Hey, how are you, my awesome friends on the internet? In this video and some of the upcoming videos, we will be discussing about some core logical blocks available in Kodular, AppyBuilder, and other platforms. Today, we are going to learn about the correct uses of procedure block and also learn some programming concepts related to it. So without any further ado, let's get started. Procedure block, as the name suggests, is used to create a custom task which we can use again and again in a screen. Procedure block is similar to a function or a method used in programming. Well, the use of procedure block is not absolutely necessary. We can still make a fully functional app even without it. But using procedure block is a good practice as it highly reduces the number of blocks used and keeps the code clean. So it is preferable to use procedure blocks when the task is carried out again and again in the app. As you can see here, there are two types of procedure blocks. Let's bring them on the screen. As you can simply notice the design, they are different for these two blocks. Different types of blocks will be attached to each of them. The first procedure block is the one which won't return any value. It is simply used to carry out an action or event which we will define here. And the second one is the one that will return a value after processing the blocks we entered here. As you can simply see, the call blocks for these procedures are also different. Also, if we click on the mutator, we will find that these procedure blocks can take inputs as well. These are like attributes to a function. So we can add as many inputs as we want in our task. To understand them better, let's make a comparison. The first procedure block can be compared to a car, where the input is petrol and the resultant output or output action is this movement. And for the second procedure that returns a value, we can compare the second procedure with a coffee maker, where the inputs are milk, sugar, and coffee powder. And the cup of coffee we get from it is the output or the resultant value it returns. To better understand the use of procedure blocks, let's create a simple app. So this is the UI of the app we plan to create. As you can see, the app is divided into two parts. In the first part, tapping each of these buttons changes the color of the car image, along with the title bar, status bar, and the navigation bar. In the second part, we have a payment form where we have to enter the customer's name and amount paid. And clicking the submit button returns a confirmation message with customer name and the amount paid by him. Now let's see how we can use procedure blocks in this app. So for that, we'll first use a procedure to color the car and other elements. So here in this procedure, let's name it car paint. So here we need to color the car. So let's take here car. Car is not actually any image, it's actually a text, a label. For it, I have simply used font awesome font for the car icon. So we have to change the color of it. As we know that clicking each of these buttons will change the color of the car differently. So here we have to use an input. So we'll use one. Let's name the input as paint. And we'll use this input with the car text or car icon, whatever you say. Now we need to change the color of status bar, title bar, and navigation bar. So let's do that. Title bar color. Again, it will be changed to similar to the paint. All will do the same. Now we can simply duplicate it for the other things. Okay. So our procedure is ready. Now we have to call this procedure to the button clicks. So let's do that. When red button clicks, do what? Just call this procedure, car paint procedure. And here you can see we are getting an input for paint. So we'll use the color here needed, that is red. It has this red button. Now we can simply duplicate it for all the other two buttons. Let's change this to green button, this to blue button, and change the color respectively. So our first part is complete here. So this is how you can use the procedure block, first procedure block. Here, as you can see, using this procedure saves lots of blocks. Here, as you can see, we would have needed three extra blocks for each of these, because we had to use all these things here, here, and here. So it would have taken a lot more of blocks. So as you can see, it simply reduced it to the minimum, and along with that, the code looks very much clean and understandable. And if the procedure is big enough, then it will look very much messy if we don't use procedures with this. And if our action is very much complex, then the code becomes also very much messy. So that's why it's better to use procedure with apps which require a repetitive action of the same kind. So now let's move on to the second part. In second part, we have two text box as you have seen, and we'll return just a message when the button clicks. When submit button clicks, we'll simply return a message. So let's add the button. And message will come in this label confirm message. At present is simply empty. But when button clicks, it will set the text to something. So we'd need a return value for this text. So for this, we can use this result procedure, because this action procedure won't fit with this block. So we'll just use this second type of procedure, which returns a value. So let's rename it as confirm, as it will show a confirm message. Now let's use join block and add a few strings to it. Strings means text in programming language, as you may be familiar. So we'll add a string block. Let's type our message. Then we have to import the name, customer name, on the text box. So we'll simply take it. So customer name the text, we will simply use from the text box. Now another dollars. Now we need the value, text value from the amount of text. Now final message. So our message is complete. Now we have to call this block. As you can see, call confirm block for the procedure that returns a value can be attached to it. So this is how you use the second procedure, second type of procedure that returns a value. Well, in this case, as you can see, it will also be okay if you don't use the procedure block, but I have used it to show you how it works. But this block is, yes, useful, as I said before, if you have multiple levels where we want to feed the value, the same value when any button clicks. In that case, using this return procedure is very much preferable. So this is how you use procedure blocks. I hope I was able to clear your concepts and teach you how to use procedure block. So if you find any doubt or didn't understand any part, do let me know in the comment section. I'll definitely reply to you and clear all your doubts or questions. So this is it for today. Subscribe to the channel, as more concept related videos are on the way. And see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.